In this video, I'm going to make this beautiful, amazing, homemade dye water level indicator with alarm using Arduino Uno board, and the music will be world famous song Despacito. So let's start building this gadget. First of all, making this, we need some wires, and these wires are for the soldering purpose, and this wire is also for soldering purpose, but connect the speakers. So the component will be given in the description, link will be given. So another thing is that we need a zero PCB, need some resistance. Basically this is 1k or 200 ohm. So all the, and this is the VC547 transistor. Two transistor we have need in this project, and 110k potentiometer. So that's very simple thing. We all have this kind of electronic components in our home if you are electronics lover. So 0.1 microfarad capacitor is also needed, and couple of LEDs, one for green, one for red. I am going to use in this project orange. And the main thing is that food container. This kind of food container is, you can find easily if you order food online. So this is a basically 750mm plastic food container. So I will give all the circuit diagram and Arduino code link in the description. You can download and can make your circuit following the circuit diagram I will give in the description. I am following also the same circuit diagram and soldering all the components in my small zero PCB board. So this is very easy, and I am going to use Arduino Uno board. If you are very useful to the Atmega 328P, you can use Atmega 328P board and IC, you can solder all together. But for the simplicity of this project, I am going to use some jumper wires, and this jumper wire will be inserted in the Arduino Uno board. So let's follow this tutorial. And here you can see the red and green is the VIN and green is for the ground. And I am going to use this kind of old radio speaker. I found this speaker from my one of the old FM radio. So I am going to use that kind of thing. But you can buy this kind of speaker local market 50 or 60 rupees in India you will find. And this is the top of the food container, plastic food container. You have to cut circle in the same size of the speaker. After that you have to make some holes using some hot soldering iron, and you have to feed the potentiometer. This potentiometer is useful to manage the volume control. So someone like the high volume of the speaker alarm, someone like low volume. For that purpose I have attached this kind of pot to control the volume. And I have used couple of transistors, because one transistor is useful, but because of this high volume transistor may burn. So I'm going to use couple of transistors so that ampere will be divided in two transistors. So the Arduino board will be attached like this. From the bottom, two screw and nut I will use to attach inside the food container. So this is pretty much useful. And I am going to use old Nokia mobile charger. So all the things you will find in your home. And I am going to use one extra micro USB connection for to connect this clock. This is also Arduino powered clock I made some months ago. In this channel you can find the video of tutorial of that. So this is optional, you can make to connect external 3 micro USB connection, but this is optional. So let's connect all together and use some hot glue gun to attach the speaker. Next you need some spring or some wires, and you need some aluminium wires or something in that way, so that you can attach the hanging purpose. You can use hang it to your wall. So for that purpose I am going to use this kind of setup. So right now all the setup has been done. So let's just check before we are going to connect to the overhead water tank. So here you can see two wires have been coming out. These wires is basically the short circuit. If you short circuit, then the starting music will start. So this is the boot tone, you can say. As soon as you start the machine or the device, the boot tone will play some 10 or 12 seconds. Then you can see, because there is no connection, the LED of red or orange, whatever, will blink. So as soon as you short circuited the two wires, which will be short circuited when the water is full. And let's enjoy this 80 second melody. So the main another thing is that you have to connect it to your overhead water tank. This is quite tough. I must say tough means you have to work hard to connect it. So need some long wires, and this wire is basically the LED connection or homemade dye LED connection, whatever LED chain, decorative LED chain. You may find this kind of wires in local market. Price is not very high, very less price, around within 100 rupees you can connect 2 or 3 overhead tanks. So that's mean per overhead tank 30 or 40 rupees. So I am now going to attach to the home, or in my first floor there is one room. I am going to attach it, the Arduino powered water level indicator from that, and from that I am going to connect 2 wires, and these 2 wires will be inside the water tank. So let's find out how I am going to attach. So we need couple of plate. This is the aluminium plate, or it is recommended to use copper plate. Right now I have aluminium plate because aluminium plate may take rust. So after that, after some days, I change that aluminium plate to the copper plate or copper wire. So you may use, and you can check which one is working good for you. So for that demonstration purpose, I am going to use aluminium plate. After that, the wires have to be inserted inside the water tank. How I'm going to insert the wires? From the exhaust. Exhaust means the overflow pipe where the overflow water drains out. From that area I'm going to insert the wires. So right now all the soldering purpose, everything has been done. I have to attach it to the tank, but before that you have to check the resistance of continuity. So here you can see the continuity inside the water. When it is water is full, then it will be around 1500 or 1600 ohms. So that is the analog value. So we have to use the analog pin of Arduino. For that purpose, first of all you have to read the Arduino value of the analog pin A0. So when there is no water, that means water is low, the value will be around 0 10 20, very low, within 20 50. Oh, analog read will be there. So my case it is 0. So as soon as the water touches these two wires, the value will be around 300 400 above it. So as good as your wires, the value will be high, but when there is no water, value will be around 0. So in that particular case, I am going to use some logic. So when it is value is above 300, it will be high, thus my water is full, and when the value is below 150, it will be low. So in that case I am going to use. So this is the coding purpose. All the code, all the circuit diagram has been given in the description, you can check out. Right now I have to set it inside the water tank. For that purpose we need 4 zip tie. Using zip tie, one of the pump. Here you can see this is the submersible pump line. In that pump line pipe I have attached it using zip tie. You can see how it looks like. So now the time to connect the overhead wires, overhead tank wires inside this water level indicator. For that purpose we have to connect using some tape, electronics tape or electrical tape from that. So just connect these two wires with the two wires coming out or open circuited in the earlier of this video. So just connect it and set up all together. At last all the making, all the setup has been done. Now this water level indicator with alarm powered by Arduino Uno is totally ready and ready to use. So let's see. So right now I am going to set up, and here you can see external 3 micro USB connection is there. So I have to connect this external micro USB, that is 5 volt DC source, to one of my die homemade clock using Arduino and also with the temperature and humidity. So I have connected in that way. When there is no water or water is low, this kind of orange or red LED will blink. So I hope you have found this video very helpful, and at least give a try at your home if you have Arduino and electronics lover. Do let me know in the comment section how much do you like this video, this project, and do subscribe to this channel, like this video, share this video and comment anything, your opinion regarding this video. I'm going to meet you in my next video. Till then, goodbye, take care.